Jules, I am back, and I just want to show you guys what I have been up to. I was watching Stacey Evans' Pink Poodlecraft Creations video on how to make tie-dye paper. You can use any type of paper, but it has to be something that can saturate, like coffee filters, deli paper, and things like that. So, I wanted to show you what I can turn these regular coffee filters into. You can turn them into beautiful pieces of artwork. Like that. Isn't that awesome? I think they are gorgeous. And I'm going to show you how I did it. I don't know if I'm following straight from what Stacy did, but I'm going to sure try. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take some cotton... some cotton twine, and we're going to cut it into some small sections. Let's cut you about 5 or 6 pieces. Doesn't have to be a precise measurement. So, alright, now that you got your pieces cut, you're going to take your coffee filter. And my favorite was the lines. So I'm going to show you exactly how I did this. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it and make folded sections like an accordion fold. It doesn't have to be in precise measurements, just fold it. Alright, now that you've got the accordion fold, I'm going to twist it. And I'm going to tie a piece of this string on here. Now when you tie this, kind of tie it pretty tight. You don't have to do it twice because it holds pretty tight if you get the right kind. Now I'm going to make another section and I'm going to fold and I'm going to tie. Pretty tight. Take another section and twist. There, please excuse my hands. This is not a craft that will keep clean hands. So, yeah, if you need to, put some gloves on. Me, I don't care. I like getting my hands dirty. Now that we've got those sections off, we are going to pull out some colors, some alcohol inks, some just dilutions, and some homemade inks that I have made. And I'm going to play with these inks. I have a little dropper, a little pipette that I have been using, and now that I go to do my video, it seems to have dropped off the face of the earth. Oh, there it is, right in front of my face, right there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this little dropper and I'm going to just open up one of these bottles and I'm just going to drop some ink straight onto the coffee filter. The coffee filters are very porous and they'll take a lot of color. Make sure you just saturate that with the color that you want. Got that. We can move on to another color. So we got red. Let's go with some mercury blue. This is a vibrant turquoise. See how it's drawing into the next part? Do it just right, you'll be able to get coloring. You might be able to get another color from that. Alright, now let's do a wild honey distress ink. like a orangey red. Let's see. Very hippie-ish. This is the color that I mixed myself, so very watery. Now let's go with. This is Broken China. Now, instead of waiting overnight to dry, I am going to speed this little process up. Get a paper towel and sop up that extra ink laying there. I am going to use my heat tool to kind of quick dry. Dying impatient. You could even reuse the strings that you use to tie-dye in, like, your mixed media artwork, because it actually turns out really pretty, too, because it dyes these strings as well. So you can use that in your mixed media artwork. Alright, I am going to take a very sharp pokey tool. Please keep in mind that these are sharp. And if you're very rough with it, you will rip your paper. Take that off. It is going to be still a little bit damp because I sped drying. You really need to leave it overnight to get all the layers dry. But I am a little impatient. I wanted to show you guys how gorgeous this turned out. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's see the final product. Give me that, cool. How pretty that is. Ripping a little bit right here, so I don't think that's too bad. But look how cool that is. I'm going to dry that up a little bit. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. This is an idea that I got from Miss Stacy Evans, Pink Little Craft Creations. You can also visit her on Facebook. She has a really neat group. If you're not a part of their group, part of that group, you're missing. So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you guys for coming in and watching this tutorial. And I hope you've learned something. And if you want the tutorial, I will hopefully be able to link that down in the description below of the full tutorial that she does. So, I will see you guys on my next video. Bye, guys.